Great thing about Colorado is just the opportunity you have to hunt.
We're about to go, if there's a pond down below us.
Brandon has a deer tag, and he was coming up here in the high country, and I figured I wanted to be in the high country this year too, and I didn't really have a deer tag, so I figured I'd pick up a over-the-counter elk tag. So I'm hunting archery elk over the counter, and Brandon's hunting archery deer.
All we did was eat breakfast this morning, Brendo.
We should have ate something, like
but
a snack.
But now I got some leftover food to go through the next couple days.
We'd have had a little bit more energy.
Dropper on his left. Did you see that?
Do we wait and see what they do this evening?
Yeah, probably. One day watching that deer is like, ugh, pulled everything out of me. I could... Like,
we might wait 3 or 4 days, but...
I ain't waiting another 2 days. Put a stock on that deer.
Well, at least tomorrow. You're going up there tomorrow.
Oh, yeah. And if I'm up there, shoot, we might as well try and put an arrow in him.
Right?
Right.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm all for just getting after it tomorrow.
And all that was above them was loose scree, and they were 800 yards off the top, off the peak.
I think it's pretty much impossible to hunt these deer. Too much noise from the avalanche chutes, and you can't get above them.
I was laying down, taking a nap. Brandon was looking for some other deer down in here, and you can hear some free-spirited nature enjoyers being pretty loud at the peak up here.
But they're only 500 to 800 yards from the deer that we bedded this morning.
Well, they were all naked at the top of the peak, being free-spirited.
Hopefully our free-spirited nature enjoyers don't mess up today's deer hunt.
Two candy bars left for today, and a spicy mountain house tonight.
And what?
A spicy mountain house. I got the chili mac and beef.
Ooh.
Love that one. You don't like it?
I can't have that one.
Some people can, some people can't.
Thank you.
I love it. There's a lot of glass bull country. It makes me a little nervous how big some of it is, like getting over there. But other than that, I love it. I mean, this is, it's a lot of country. There's definitely going to be deer to be turned up in here. There's no question.
How's that palace?
It's awesome.
Room for two in there?
Yeah.
Yesterday, we saw three hunters coming through the bottom of this basin right here. But this morning, I come and roll out to this ridge right here to start glassing, and behind me, I hear some footsteps, and I turn around, and I introduce myself. Long story short, he's with two guys out of Alabama, so we started talking about elk hunting and sat here for the better part of an hour, probably, hour and a half, and just talked. They said they'd stop by camp tonight. Today's like borderline depressing with how little bit of deer we've seen. The only good news is we found a pretty big bull. He's just a long ways away. If we go after him, the deer hunt's pretty much over. And we come back to camp tonight, and we run into our buddies from down the way that are elk hunting, and they say that they ran into a good buck off the trail.
We came up from the bottom, and we weren't on the trail, and we saw them. They went up onto the trail. We tried to hand deliver like we promised.
Yeah, right. So they're gonna be in there tomorrow morning?
I don't think they're going very far. They weren't scared.
Look, this is the best footage is gonna be right.
Let me see. I think.
Oh no, we shoot him.
Oh yeah, we definitely shoot that buck. No question, we shoot
him. It's a 5x5. Yeah. He had little devil points coming out.
In sweet. The west, it's a 4-point. We don't count, I guess.
Oh, you don't count. No.
I think our plan's pretty good for tomorrow. I mean, nothing beats just fresh intel from people that barely got into camp after seeing the deer, so I think it's a better plan than we've had.
Guess I need two shots. I wish they made trail mix with no raisins. Probably have to make my own trail mix. Just peanuts and M&Ms. Almonds.
You know, that it's pretty frustrating, pretty discouraging. I mean, after spending 7 days and not having a stalking opportunity and finally getting one, getting into range, and you know, it just wears on you.
I'm telling you, it's the greatest. It's my absolute favorite, hands down. It's got all the flavor that biscuits and gravy has. Yeah, it's got it all.
Okay, let's have a look.
It's not done yet. You don't get to see the masterpiece till it's done.
Ah, Chef Lorenzo.
On biscuits and gravy, it's my favorite one. I don't mess with this one.
It's the simple joys in the backcountry that
it really
make
is,
you happy.
Though.
Thank you.
bucks a buck, man. He hammered him. I'm soaked with that deer. That's pretty cool. Oh, guys.
To be flat honest, any buck up in here is a freaking stuff, like stuff in my book. Like, I know we're only like 150 yards from camp, but still, we're 8 miles from the truck, so we'll earn him either way we look at it.
We've hunted a lot of basins.
Yeah.
A lot.
Yeah.
A successful hunt to me is one that I learned from, one that I enjoy the time spent. It's always a bonus to get the animal that you're after. You know, I'm not gonna say that I'm just all for the journey. You know, I'm going out there for a reason. I'm a hunter at heart.
If we were gonna spend another night in camp tonight, we'd be eating this up here. But I guess we'll just head to the truck and I'll eat it with my wife at home.
You know, there's a lot of perks to harvesting a deer. But I think a lot of what a successful hunt goes into is who you're hunting with, and the experiences that you make while you're doing it.